Okay, thank you to the media for joining us. We're going to wait here a little bit as some of the participants file in, and then we'll get started. All right, I think that is the list right now. So welcome to today's post-press conference Zoom availability with Ben Kennedy and Mayor Lori Lightfoot, Mayor of the City of Chicago. Obviously, we had an exciting press conference today. Big announcement of the Chicago street course next year on July 2nd, 2023. Maybe we'll just start off, Ben, with you. Talk about just a quick overview of your thoughts of today, the big announcement, and all the work that went into this exciting announcement.
Yeah, thank you, Mike. And a monumental day for the sport of NASCAR. You know, we'll be celebrating our 75th year anniversary next year, and we'll be having our very first street race in our sports history here in downtown Chicago. So really such a special day. A big thank you to the city of Chicago, certainly Mayor Lori Lightfoot here, Cara Bachman at the Sports Commission, everyone that helped bring this to fruition. It's it was another vision that our team had a couple of years ago, and it's so great to see it come to fruition here and be able to announce it.
Open society.
Thank you, Ben. If you have your computer not on mute, please mute it. We're getting a little bit of feedback. Okay, thank you, everybody. And now to you, Mayor. On stage, you mentioned it perfectly. This is the sports city, amazing sports city. What does it mean to have NASCAR join the ranks of the Cubs, the White Sox, Bulls, Bears, and so many others?
Well, I think that there's going to be a tremendous amount of excitement. We already saw that today by passersby joining the early announcement. And I think the NASCAR Nation is going to gravitate toward Chicago and to see the first of its kind road race in the city of Chicago. They're going to be passing by very iconic parts of our city, including Grant Park, Buckingham Fountain, Soldier Field, Millennium Park. The list really goes on. And I think this is going to be an opportunity to really showcase the city on an international stage. So we are extraordinarily excited, and hats off to NASCAR. They've been tremendous partners, Ben and his mom and the whole NASCAR team. We are really super excited for July of 2023.
Thank you, Mayor. Now, Ben, Mayor, and to the media, I'm sharing my screen, as you can see. What about to show is a flyover of the course that we will see in actuality, in reality, next July. Ben, Mayor, I will leave it up to you to maybe give us some perspective of what we're watching, the turns, passing zones, some of the iconic landmarks that we'll be flying through. So let me just go ahead and share my screen, and I will start rolling the video. Okay.
Great. Yeah, so I can jump in and there. Certainly, feel free to add some light to it as well. So, yeah, the setting is, I mean, it's downtown Chicago, right in the heart of Grant Park. We're just gonna go do a quick fly through here. So this will be going south down Columbus. You have Buckingham Fountain off to the left, off to the right, and we'll see it at the end of the video. A lot of suites and hospitality areas that we're going to create. This is where Pit Road's going to be. So you have Pit Road on the right, the racing groove on the left. Make a left onto Balbo, a right onto Lakeshore, and then we're heading south down Lakeshore. You have a stage off to the right in Lower Hutchinson Fields. They're going to make a right around Roosevelt. And then we'll come back up on Columbus. And I'll say when we head now northbound here on Columbus, this is going to be our widest portion of the track. So, you know, 7 lanes wide, I think a lot of passing zones here. You have the entire Chicago skyline as a backdrop, which is certainly going to be something remarkable. Looks like we're jumping ahead. So now we're on Balbo. We're going to make a right back onto Michigan here. We're going to do the half circle, which is Congress, connects with IW Wells, and then the cars will cross back to Michigan again. They'll make their penultimate turn here onto Jackson, and then they'll come up on their final corner which will bring them back to Columbus and the start finish line. So a 2.2 mile 12 term course, again in the heart of Chicago, and we'll probably fly through some of the hospitality areas here. So still in design and working on what this would look like. These aren't the final renderings at all, but kind of a two-story structure that our team has been taking a look at. Certainly a lot of hospitality options in and around here. You also have suites and grandstands on this side, a lot of GA areas that are spread out around the park. So really want to make it, a mobile friendly, venue and event. And really something special for our fans. And I think that the track will put on a tremendous race.
Well, and Ben, if I can jump in, I think what you've seen in this kind of virtual tour provides not only, I think, great sight lines for our iconic Grand Park, but what I also envision is not only fans taking advantage of the stands that are gonna be set up, but you're gonna see viewing parties that are going to be hosted in a lot of these downtown high-rises and hotels. So I think the opportunities for viewing, but also the opportunities for our hospitality industry to really benefit from this great race are going to be off the charts. So we're excited, and I think it's nothing like it's going to have happened before in the city of Chicago, and I think it just opens up the innovation and boldness that NASCAR has really become known for. So again, it's going to be a tremendous partnership.
Well, thank you, Mayor. And you clearly get NASCAR. That's exactly right. That was beautiful. We'll open it up to questions now to the media. If you have one, please raise your hand and we'll get to you, time permitting. We'll open up the questions to Bob Pockers. Go ahead, Bob.
Yeah, for either of you, That video made the roads look very smooth. So is everything going to be repaved and what other construction will need to be done prior to the event? I mean, do any of the medians or anything need to be removed or altered? Thank you.
Yeah, so that's a good question, Bob. And, we've certainly been working with some of the different city departments on what that would look like. CDOT in particular. We've had our design development and competition folks come out and look at the surface. We've also had one of our asphalt experts look at the surface as well. And, I'd say, thankfully, I had the opportunity to drive around the park earlier today. The roads are in really good condition. I think there'll probably be a few small improvements that will need to be made. But, for the most part, I think it will be in really good shape. And, I think with our next-gen cars and the way that they've been designed, we'll certainly be able to take on the streets well.
Next, we'll go to Nate Ryan. Go ahead, Nate.
Thanks, Ford. I got a couple. I don't know if this would be for the mayor or for Ben, but could you give some specific reasons as to why this location and this layout made the most sense, whether it's the footprint, whether it's the backdrop? What specific reasons led to you choosing this location?
Well, Ben, why don't you start and then I'll jump in.
Okay. Yeah. So, I think for us, and we looked at a handful of different locations around the city of Chicago. Grant Park was one that just came to mind almost instantaneously. You think about how iconic that park is, Buckingham Fountain, all the special and iconic shots of the city skyline and monuments around that park. Certainly a very special place. And it just so happened that we were able to create a course on iRacing with our partners and be able to actually test it in the summer of last year with our cup drivers and get feedback on the course. And thankfully the feedback was really positive from a racing perspective. So I think it'll offer many different passing zones. And I think it's a perfect setting for it. The city puts on some amazing events, down in Grant Park, and, great to be, another one on that list.
And I would just add that, first and foremost, we needed to obviously work with NASCAR to make sure that the location was picked made sense for the driving and the drivers. But for our perspective, as Ben just said, we put on big events in our downtown and particularly around Grant Park on a regular basis all throughout our spring, summer, and fall. So we know how to do this. We'll be working hand in glove with NASCAR to make sure that the experience is safe, but also incredibly enjoyable for the fans. And if you know anything about the city of Chicago, you probably know our tremendous lakefront and icons like Grant Park and Buckingham Fountain. So I'm looking forward to showcasing our fantastic city on a global stage. And we're going to do everything we can to make sure that this race is a love letter to the city of Chicago.
Great. A couple of quick follow-ups. Ben, you said you mentioned you looked at other locations. Were there any outside downtown, or were there any others that you were close to maybe choosing instead of this one? Or
no, we looked at a handful of them. You know, I would say, again, Grant Park was just, it really is a no-brainer for us. Again, with you know, the great city streets that Chicago has to offer, the number of events that they've had here. And you think about the aerial shots when NBC, you know, covers this event next year, to be flying over Lake Michigan, looking down on Grant Park, and then having that iconic Chicago skyline as a backdrop, it's going to be something unlike anyone's ever seen before. So certainly a great city to be in for our first ever street course race. And I couldn't think of a better location in the city of Chicago than Grant Park.
Last one for Ben, the IMSA race, is that a WeatherTech race, a Michelin pilot race? Have you figured out like where you're going to be on that?
Yeah, it's a good question. Working very closely with John Doonan and their team on what that's going to look like. It will be one of the IMSA sanctioned series. Not sure exactly what that series is going to be, but no, it's going to be a great addition to the weekend schedule.
Great, thanks.
Next, we'll go to Jordan Bianchi. Go ahead, Jordan.
Couple questions for me. The first question is, Mayor, can you tell me what the city's cost for this event is?
I'm sorry, I'm having a difficult time hearing you. Can you repeat?
No problem. What is the cost? What is the cost for the city to pay for this event?
Well, we'll be working out the details of this with NASCAR. And once we have those specifics, we'll be happy to share them with you. But I will also say this. The kind of corollary to your question is, what are the benefits to the city? And while this is the first of its kind, so we don't have hard numbers yet, I will tell you that, for example, an event like Lollapalooza, it's over $300 million in economic impact. So we expect this to be a substantial financial benefit to the city, and particularly for our hotels, our restaurants, and other forms of entertainment.
Very good. My second question is for Ben. Ben, when did the genesis for this idea come about, and when did you start working on it?
I'd say the genesis for this idea is probably sometime around when we came up with the idea of the LA Coliseum back in the fall of 2019. So kind of had this concept that we've been working on for a little while, and certainly working with TSMGI to bring that to fruition for the virtual event last year. But then I would say the work really started, probably a year or so ago, and really over the past 90 days, a majority of that work has happened culminating in today and today's event. So, you know, certainly a lot of work that's been done, to the mayor's point, a lot of work that we still have to do in site planning and ultimately, you know, what this event, the different elements of the event are going to look like. We'll be certainly working hand in hand with the city and the city departments to make sure that we do that. We make a special event experience for those coming and attending, and for the folks in Chicago, that we have a positive impact here and really, just a minimal impact on kind of lifestyle as well.
Quick follow-up to the mayor. You said you're going to be working with the NASCAR to kind of finalize the details and everything on this. Is there a way that this race could not come to fruition next year somehow, some way?
Well, I don't see that happening. Now, I say that in the context of coming out of a global pandemic. So, you know, we can't look into a crystal ball and know what's going to happen. But all things being equal, it's full steam ahead. We are very, very excited about this partnership and working with NASCAR and bringing, I think, this incredibly important opportunity to our residents and really to a global stage.
Thank you both.
Next, we'll go to Greg Engel. Go ahead, Greg. Hi, let me get myself off mute. Your Honor, I live in Orlando, but I'm a huge Chicago fan, so I just want to say congratulations and keep up the great work. And I can't wait to be there. I can't wait to be there next year to cover this race. But my question is for you, Mr. Kennedy. What do you tell the folks at Road America? Because that seemed to be a pretty successful venue.
a lot of fans, a lot of buzz about that, but now they're kind of left out in the dark, so to speak. So what would be your message to the folks at Road America?
Yeah, you know, I think that's a fair question, Greg. And you know, we've had some great racing at Road America, certainly the past 2 years of the NASCAR Cup Series, much longer than that with the NASCAR Xfinity Series, and have been great partners. And we've seen, you know, a great turnout from a fan perspective as well. So we've seen some great racing there. You know, that said, it is unfortunate that we're not going back in 2023. And, you know, just because it's a no for 2023 doesn't mean that's necessarily a no forever. You know, we've got some great partners up there, and you know, we'll certainly share more about what the other national series schedules look like in the future. But I think part of the calculus of the decision, certainly, you know, similar kind of market as you think about the proximity of the two venues from each other. And then, you know, I think it's also important just as we think about the number of types of tracks that we have on the schedule. You know, something that we've heard is kind of the number of road courses, continuing to add road courses on the schedule. And you know, I think it's important that we don't oversaturate ourselves. I won't say that, you know, was the impetus of the decision. There were a number of things that kind of went into that decision, you know, but certainly really appreciate all that they've done up there. And we'll certainly be in touch with them.
Thank you. And again, Mayor, I look forward to seeing you, and we'll get some hot dogs next year. Congratulations again, folks.
We I'll show you my favorite spots. We'll welcome you with open arms.
Looking forward to it, ma'am.
Mayor Lightfoot, I thank you so much for all your time. We're going to let you go. I know you have a busy rest of the day. Thank you for joining us for so much time, starting early with the press conference. Have a great rest of the day, and congratulations on this big announcement.
Thank you, and look forward to seeing you all next year here in our great city.
Okay, we'll continue with questions for Ben Kennedy, and our next one will go to Matt Weaver. Go ahead, Matt.
I'm on mute, wasn't I? Sorry about that. Thanks, Ben, for your time today. I've got two for you. Listen, it's a radical decision, and sometimes with radical decisions comes pushback from a legacy fan who doesn't quite fully know what to make of it, right? And so for the skeptics, what would you want them to know about why this is not only good for NASCAR, but good for them as a NASCAR fan and the type of show they're going to get in downtown Chicago?
Yeah, thanks for your question, Matt. You know, I think as we think about all of our scheduling initiatives, it's a fine balance, right? We want to continue to celebrate the tradition and the legacy that a lot of our events have. So, you know, whether it be the Daytona 500, the Coke 600, you know, Bristol Night Race, Darlington on Labor Day weekend, those are all iconic moments in our schedule. You know, that said, where there's opportunities for us to innovate, you know, LA Coliseum being exhibit A of that, we're gonna innovate, and you know, we're gonna be bold. And but I think for us, you know, and take the Coliseum as an example, being able to do something like that in a downtown location that's fun, that's exciting, that's a little bit different. Certainly, you know, we have a lot of our avid fans come out, which is fantastic. We also had a lot of new fans come out as well. And, you know, I think we'll see the same thing here in Chicago. Probably have a lot of fans that may have gone out to Chicagoland or Road America or Worldwide Technology Raceway that might come out and experience the event here in Chicago. Frankly, we'll probably also have a lot of new fans as well. You know, folks that may have not been to a NASCAR race before and may want to come to watch a racing or, you know, see the A-list headliners that we're going to have on the stage at Lower Hudson Fields or just be able to experience it. So, you know, that's all part of our strategic rationale behind it. And, you know, I think as we think longer term, certainly opens the door for us, similar to Coliseum, to new markets in the future as well.
And then the next gen car has been really successful, but the one weak spot is kind of flat tracks, short tracks, and some road courses similar to what this layout should be. So if Chicago is basically Martinsville with a couple of right turns from looking at it, are you guys getting to a place of confidence after the test at Martinsville and some of the other things that you want to try to not only get ready for that race this fall, but probably for some of the challenges this track could have for a similar kind of situation?
Sure. Yeah. And I would say to your point, you know, the racing this year, and if you look at every metric across the board, whether it's passes for the lead, passes throughout the field, the margin of victory, the delta between first and second, almost every one of those metrics are up significantly, or even the highest that we've ever seen since we started electronic scoring. So I'd say a majority of that has really happened at the intermediate tracks in the mile and a half. You know, to your point, some of the short tracks have some work to do on. I know Steve O'Donnell, John Probst, and the team up in the R&D center, they're testing out different things, to your point, testing at Martinsville Speedway. So that's certainly a focus of ours, both as we think about the existing schedule and putting on the best racing for our fans from now through Phoenix. But as we think about this event next year as well, you know, I think the next gen car will lend itself well to the streets of Chicago. You know, but we're certainly going to be working closely with teams, OEs, and our drivers to make sure that it really puts on a good race here, certainly alongside Goodyear as well, and put on a great race for our fans.
Thanks, Ben.
Next, we go to Deb Williams. Go ahead, Deb.
Thank you, and thank you, Ben, for your time today. In the mid-1980s, NASCAR floated having an LR series, i.e. left-right series, and they tabled that, I think, probably because of the car. What instrumental role or how instrumental was the role of this next-gen car in knowing this was the correct time to go street car racing for NASCAR?
Yeah, that's a great question, Deb. And I think the next-gen car is a big part of that. Certainly, we didn't develop the next-gen car to go street course racing, but the next-gen car, I think, is going to perform really well in the street course. And you know, we've seen some decent racing this year on the road courses so far. I think the racing product itself will be very similar to it. And, you know, with the kind of ride height that the next gen cars have, and then the look and style of them, you know, actually going around the streets with the relevance that our OE partners developed into them, I think they're going to look, first of all, they're going to look phenomenal on the streets here in Chicago, but they're going to put on a great race for our fans as well. So certainly the next gen car has been a huge part of that. And I know they will be really, really excited to watch here in Chicago.
Okay, thank you. Looking forward to it.
Thanks.
I know there are several questions left, but Ben needs to run. Thank you all for joining today. And apologies to those who didn't get their question asked. We'll have the content, the video, audio, and transcript of today's engagement on NASCARmedia.com. And Ben, thank you for your time. And to the media, thank you for your time. Have a great rest of the day.
Thanks, Ben. Thanks, Ken.
Thank you, everyone, for your time.